Use a 19mm socket to remove the track bar bolt at the axle. Save all the hardware. Install the axle mount hand tight using the track bar's stock hardware. Center punch the second hole and drill it out with a 3/8 inch drill bit. Using a 14mm socket and wrench, install the provided bolt. Fully tighten all of the hardware. Using an 18mm socket, fully disconnect the stock steering stabilizer from the Jeep. Using a 13mm socket, remove the three bolts holding the stabilizer plate to the axle. Save the top stabilizer plate hardware. Using a 10mm socket, remove the one bolt located on the side of the stock axle disconnect. Save this bolt. Using a 10mm socket, remove the two bolts located on the bottom of the stock axle disconnect skid. Align the MetalCloak front axle skid plate to the existing holes and install the stock stabilizer hardware hand tight. Install the saved 10mm stock hardware hand tight. Install the provided Allen head bolt into the bottom of the skid plate using a 6mm Allen head wrench. Tighten all of the axle disconnect skid plate's hardware. Using the provided bolt, install the steering stabilizer into the stabilizer axle mount. Place the tie rod bracket onto the tie rod. Add the U-bolts, nylock nuts, and washers to hold the plate in place. Attach the stabilizer to the tie rod mount and use the nut to secure the stabilizer to the bracket. Tighten the tie rod mount nylock nuts with a 7/16 socket. Tighten the hardware on both ends of the stabilizer using a 19mm socket. Make sure all the hardware is fully tightened. Once the installation is completed, make sure the steering can turn lock to lock without any interference.